Good morning, students. I welcome the first year students in today's class, and today I am going to teach you a literary term, a figure of speech called hyperbole. It is a very important literary term and used by many poets of all centuries. Hyperbole is a figure of speech which means exaggeration of facts. Exaggeration means overstatement, giving more importance, more stress than it is important to any fact is called hyperbole. It can be used for comic as well as serious effects. In short, hyperbole is a figure of speech which means overstatement, exaggeration, and luxurious exaggeration of facts. So the question comes, what is hyperbole? So hyperbole, as I told you, is a figure of speech which means exaggeration, exaggerated statements or a claim. They are not meant to be taken literally. So when we say that he drowned in tears, we all know that nobody can drown in his own tears. Nobody can cry so much that he can drown. But the effect the writer wants to create is that a person cried a lot. He cried in such a manner, so heavily, that this statement is used, that he drowned in his tears. So it is not to be taken literally. So in our day-to-day life also, unconsciously we used hyperboles, and especially it is used in the world of literature by poets as well as other authors. For example, I am so hungry I could eat a horse. So the expression is not to be taken literally, because we know that nobody can be so hungry, or a hunger could not be so intense that a person can eat the whole horse. So this is an example of hyperbole, because the writer wants to lay stress on the fact that the person is very, very hungry. So here in this example, you are laying stress on your hunger. You are emphasizing on hunger. So here, eating horse is not as much important as the fact that the person is hungry. Then, I heard that a million times. So when we listen to a story or a fact or any rule, many times we get irritated and we stop a person repeating that fact or a story or a rule by saying that I heard that a million times. So this is an example of hyperbole, because it is exaggerated in order to sound impressive. We all know that nobody can speak a thing or repeat a thing a million times. But in order to lay stress on the repetition, on the fact of repetition, this hyperbole is used, that I have heard that a million times. I nearly died laughing. So this is an example of hyperbole, because you couldn't simply die from laughing. So here, the point the writer wants to lay stress on is that a person laughed a lot. He laughed so much that this exaggeration has been used, that I nearly died of laughing. Though we all know that nobody can die of laughing. It is obvious, in order to sound impressive. Another example. He is 100 feet tall. So in order to lay stress on the height of a person, on extraordinary height of a person, we generally say he is 100 feet tall. This is another example of hyperbole. He could not be literally 100 feet tall, we all know, but it is a hyperbole in order to lay stress on the fact that he is extraordinarily tall. Now, let us cite examples from our course of study. So, we have done the poem Ice and Fire. This poem is filled with paradoxes as well as hyperboles. So, the hyperbole used over there is that the ice is not melting, coming in contact with fire, but it is growing hard and hard. On the other hand, the fire is not getting extinguished by coming in contact with ice, but it is burning more and more. So this is an example of hyperbole in the poem Ice and Fire by Edmund Spenser. Another example of hyperbole is to be found in the poem Go and Catch a Falling Star. The poem itself is hyperbolical. He says that there can be no woman who is beautiful as well as loyal in the whole world. Now, we all know that this can't be true, that in the whole world there can't be a woman who holds these two qualities of beauty as well as loyalty. But the author lays stress on this fact again and again. Actually, it is a generalization. It is a generalization of his personal experience. He found that beautiful women often ditched him. So he wrote this generalized poem, Go and Catch a Falling Star, and he gives a lot of impossibilities, and he says that all these impossibilities are possible. He says that running and catching a star from the sky, falling star from the sky, is possible. He says that you can know who cleft the devil's foot, you can know the history of the world from the advent of it, and he says that you can also see a mermaid singing, but it is impossible for you to find a woman who is beautiful as well as loyal. So this is the greatest hyperbole of this poem. Another hyperbole found in this poem is that he says, go and have a ride of 10,000 miles till age grows snow white hair on thee. He says, we all know that nobody can travel for 10,000 days and nights. But he says that you should travel for 10,000 days and night, and when you return, you will be filled with a lot of experiences and lot of various events which you met during your journey, but you will swear that in this journey of 10,000 days and nights, you did not find a single woman who is beautiful as well as loyal. Now, we all know that it is not possible that a person can't find a woman who is beautiful as well as loyal in this whole world. Plus, another example of hyperbole in the same poem is that he says that if anyone finds a lady who is beautiful as well as loyal, going to that lady will be compared to a pilgrimage. Now again, it is hyperbole when he says that it is a pilgrimage, that finding and going and approaching to that lady who is loyal as well as beautiful is a pilgrimage. So these are examples of hyperbole. Another example to be found in our poems is went to the sessions. In this poem, the poet William Shakespeare says, then can I drown an eye unused to flow. Now, when he is remembering all his past incidents, he remembers his lost friends. He bemoans the death of his relatives and nears and dears. He feels sad about the vanished sight of his life. He also moans for a lot of things in his life which he wanted to achieve but he could not. But he says that when such a serious session is going on in his mind, then can I drown my eye unused to flow. So he says it is then that I can cry heavily. See, drown an eye means drown his eyes into tears. We all know that nobody can cry so much that he will drown his eyes. But here, in order to lay stress on the fact that he feels sorrowful, he feels so sad that he cries heavily. Then again, in the same poem, the last couplet, but the while I think on thee, dear friend, all sorrows are restored and all sorrows end. Again, we can say that it is a hyperbole. He says that though I have experienced a lot of sorrows in my life, but still whenever I weigh my sorrows with the joy of having this friend, the fair youth, I balance the sorrows with this single joy. And then I can forget about all my sorrows and all my losses are restored the moment when I think of my friend. So if we search, there are a lot of hyperboles in our course of study, and I hope you understood hyperbole. Now let me revise. What is a hyperbole? Hyperbole is an exaggerated statement or a claim. It is an overstatement giving more emphasis or stress than is needed. But it is a poetic device because the author wants to lay stress on a particular fact by using a hyperbole. Hyperbole is not to be taken literally, and it is used by story writers, poets, novelists and dramatists, all sorts of authors, but mainly it is used by poets in order to lay stress on a certain fact. So I gave you example from day-to-day life so that you may understand, and then I also gave you examples from your course of study. So I hope you understood what is hyperbole. And if we compare hyperbole with another figure of speech,